Jan, hér er sen. Ég tala við þig á ensku. Ég vona fólk skilji þú. Ég tók þig nú bara inn í þáttinn með stuttum fyrirvara. Ég hitti þig í gær. You are a journalist from NRC Handelsblad, which is a very respected newspaper in Holland. Mm-hmm. I wanted to ask you about whether the views in Holland towards ISAVE, because the ISAVE affair is not only in Britain, but it's also in Holland. Mm-hmm. Can you tell me about that?
Yes, ISAVE started in May of this year and left Holland beginning of October with €2 billion. So that's quite a lot of money. Then the Dutch government took action. The first thing what they did was going to Iceland, because they realized that Iceland could not live up to its obligation to pay all these individual people who had put money in ISAVE a guarantee of €20,000. Iceland didn't have the money. So on the 10th of October, the first loan that Iceland got was €1,100 million from Holland, so that Iceland could live up to its obligations and pay these €20,000. Mm-hmm. Then the guarantee in Holland is €80,000. So all people who have put money in ISAVE get back €100,000. But that's not the end of the story. Now it starts. Because about €400 million of this total of €2 billion was put in ISAVE by lower authorities, like provinces, districts, and cities. Mm-hmm. And this is taxpayers' money.
Yes.
And so these people have the obligation to get back as much of this money. And this is not covered by that loan.
No.
So since then there have been negotiations between the government of Holland and the government of Iceland, until now without result.
Yes.
And now, according to the information of my newspaper, the Dutch government puts on the screws and says, we will not support the loan from the IMF to Iceland until this question has been solved. And what they mean by that is that Iceland has to pay all the damages, all the debts which ISAVE has made in Holland. And that
So your newspaper, which is, yes, I think the most respected newspaper in Holland, is of the view that Holland is blocking the help from the IMF help.
No, it's not the view. It has been informally confirmed by the Ministry of Finance. So it's not our view, but it is the Ministry of Finance who has given a hint, yes, this is what we are going to do, or what we have been doing, because we do not know what happened exactly in the IMF, but I have to remember you. First it was supposed the decision would be taken last week. Yes. And now it has been postponed to Monday. So we don't know what happens until Monday.
Do you think this is fair towards Iceland?
Well, is it unfair to ask the debts and the damages which somebody has done? In the case of ISAVE, it was quite spectacular. They just closed the office, closed the website, and people were just asking, why are they gone? Yeah, they went back to Iceland.
They just left?
They just left. Beginning of October.
They just left?
Yes. People wanted to check their accounts, maybe put money in, put money out. Yeah. Didn't work anymore.
This is criminal.
Well, I would not go that far, but anyway, it was surprising.
Yes. But what do you think, you are a Dutch journalist, you are covering Iceland, what do you think about the, well, when we talked about yesterday, you talked about the sort of the incestuous relationship in Iceland.
Well, I think, you know, this is not to be insulting, but it makes the process making sometimes a little bit slow. I would think, for example, that many experts all over the world have said, you know, if you have a central bank, then it's a good thing to have a banker on top of it. And I think this is a view which is also supported by many people and experts in Iceland. And so one of the first thing is that you have to try to realize how much damage has been done to the position of Iceland, the reputation of Iceland. Do we still have trust? And if not, you know, then we have to have a new team.
Yeah.
It's like in football, you know. Iceland was playing in the first division, now it's certainly in the third division.
Uh-huh.
So what you need is a new team, fresh, young people, and there is talent enough. But the decision process goes so slowly that people ask themselves, you know, what's really happening? That's also in the question with this ISAFE. Yeah. The Prime Minister says here, these are two things, the loan from the IMF and this question with Holland and Britain. Yeah. But, you know, these are not two things. If Holland is asked to give loan or support something or take part in the package which Scandinavian countries are talking about, then it has to, you know, the money has to come from somewhere. And this is taxpayers' money, 400 million.
Yeah.
So, I mean, what do you expect the government of Holland to do? Yeah. Or in any case, if something would happen like that, what would you expect the government of Iceland to do?
Yeah, yeah,
try to guide back.
In Iceland, we are sort of spinning this, I think the government in a way is spinning this as a patriotic issue. We will not...
Yeah, well, I mean, I would think, you know, if you want to play in the first division, you have to be aware that the rules are different than you think they are in Iceland.
Yeah.
This is the international world.
Yeah.
So, I can't see this as a patriotic thing. I just turn it around. There would be a Dutch bank coming here and leaving after 6 months with 2 billion euros and saying hi, bye-bye.
Yeah.
Well, the nation would be very angry.
Yeah. Yeah.
And rightly so.
Yeah. But now we are asking the Chinese to lend us money, so this is a, seems the situation is a bit chaotic.
Well, that is what I'm saying. I mean, first it was Russia,
yeah,
and then there's a sort of shopping around. Now we end up in the other side of the world.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that is because, you know, you have to make decisions. And I think every expert says if you don't make a loan with the IMF, you lose even more trust in the world than you already have. So I think it's a very important and dangerous game, maybe. We will see.
Jan Gerritsen, thank you for coming.
Hollensk stjórnvöld hafa beitt áhrifum sínum til að koma í veg fyrir að Íslendingar fái lán hjá Alþjóðagjaldeyrissjóðnum. Þetta hefur þarlent dagblað eftir heimildum úr fjármálaráðuneyti landsins.
Innlagnir á ISAFE-reikninga Landsbankans í Hollandi nema mörg hundruð milljörðum íslenskra króna. Viðræðum milli yfirvalda á Íslandi og í Hollandi vegna reikninganna ekki lokið. Málið þvælist á meðan fyrir samningum Íslendinga við Alþjóðagjaldeyrissjóðinn, segir blaðamaður hjá virtu hollensku dagblaði sem var gestur í Silfur Egils í dag.
According to the information of my newspaper, the Dutch government puts on the screws and says we will not support the loan from the IMF to Iceland until this question has been solved. And what they mean by that is that Iceland has to pay all the damages, all the debts which ISAFE has made in Holland. And that
so your newspaper, which is, yes, I think the most respected newspaper in Holland, is of the view that Holland is blocking the help from the IMF help.
No, it's not the view. It has been informally confirmed by the Ministry of Finance. So it's not our view, but it is the Ministry of Finance who has given a hint, yes, this is what we are going to do, or what we have been doing.